Learn about all the announcements that happened at Microsoft Build, including SQL Server 2022 Public Preview, Azure SQL Database Ledger, and a whole bunch of developer updates this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by the famous Bob Ward. Bob, thanks so much for coming on the show again.
And I'm so happy to be on your show. I would say you're the more famous person. I occasionally get invited. I feel it's a privilege and honor whenever I get asked to become on the famous Anna Hoffman's Data Exposed show. So yeah, it's great to be here today.
Well, we can agree to disagree on that one, but super excited to have you on the show. You know, we're coming off the whirlwind of Microsoft Build, just wrapped up a couple days ago. What are your thoughts? What are kind of your reactions to Build?
Yeah, you know, Build is such a great event for so many years for Microsoft and for the developer community. It's become more than just actually for the developer community. And as you know, we like to make announcements at things like Build. Build's a great event, these Microsoft events, to make announcements. And we certainly did that here, for sure. Made some pretty cool announcements. In fact, I would say I would call Build 2022 the aftermath of SQL. It sounds like a movie, doesn't it?
The aftermath of SQL. And what does that mean? Why do you call it that?
Well, it's just because, you know, we had this momentum build up to this event, and then we made some pretty big announcements. And so, you know, you or I are talking about the aftermath of those announcements. So
I love it. Yeah. So for those who missed some of the big announcements, maybe they got a clue from the title of this episode. But we're going to go through all of them. We're going to get some more details, tell folks how they can learn more. So, Bob, what were, you know, when I think about Build, one of the first things I noticed was some announcement that Rohan made. Can you share a little bit, like, what was he talking about?
Yeah, let's do it. Let's dive in and talk about that some a little bit. Aftermath for SQL. It just sounded catchy. So, but yeah. No, seriously, you know, when you think about what we do today with data for Azure data, Anna, you and I both work for the Azure Data Organization. We work on all sorts of different technologies. I work on anything that's got the word SQL on it. But think about these things. Think about governance, about analytics, databases together. People feel like this diagram almost feels a little fractured, right? So Rohan announced a new initiative for Microsoft called the Microsoft Intelligent Data Platform. And the idea is that can we bring the assets together we have in Azure Data and give that seamless integrated feel for these three areas? For databases, for analytics, and governance. And notice how they kind of build on each other, right? Operational databases can build on analytics. Governance can be used to actually centrally control and give you lineage and give you insights into what's going on for analytics and databases, right? So that's the idea. You're going to see a lot more from Microsoft in the future about this name, about the Intelligent Data Platform name. And in fact, if you think about it, think about the other cloud services from Microsoft, this platform can power all of that, whether it's Dynamics, Microsoft 365, or even Power Platform. So what you saw from Rohan was a taste of what we're seeing here in the future, a very integrated way and an actual simpler way for people to use Azure Data Cloud Services.
No, I love it. And like you said, I think we'll all be looking forward to seeing, you know, what else comes out of this, you know, new platform that we're talking about. No problem. Now, of course, I want to jump into like the biggest announcement from the SQL Server side, and that was SQL Server 2022 Public Preview. Can you tell us about it and what it means? And for folks who didn't even know that, what it is?
Yeah. So yeah, as you know, Anne, I've been working in SQL Server technology now for 29 years. And anytime I get to be involved in announcements for what we're doing in a release, it's pretty exciting. It's pretty exciting internally to craft together the story. It's obviously super exciting for our customers to finally get their hands on something. You know, we started this journey for this particular release of SQL Server last November, making an announcement of a private preview. And we've had the excitements there, obviously, from many different customers of what this can provide. But, you know, everybody's like, I want to download it. I want to use it. So it's very exciting to get a chance in Rohan's session and in my session to announce the public preview of SQL Server 2022. And as you may have seen, if you watched me right out of the gate, I said, I'm sure you just want to download it. You know, forget Bob's talking points. Like, just go get the bit. So here's the link right here again, Anna. AKDynamics Get SQL Server 2022. Just go to that link. You'll be able to pull off the evaluation edition of the public preview of SQL Server 2022. We call that CTP 2.0. Community Technology Preview 2.0. That's traditionally the number we use when we go public preview. We've been in the CTP 1.x range ever since last November. So yeah, it's really cool to just be part of this and get to see the excitement around it, get to see people finally downloading it and giving us the feedback that we need as we move into the rest of this calendar year and eventually making it generally available.
Awesome. Yeah, I know we probably lost half our viewers right then. They've just gone to the link, they're downloading it, they're getting ready to play with it.
I forget what he's saying. I'm going right now to download the link.
But for those that stuck around, like, there's a lot of stuff in this already as a public preview. What are some of like the big things to you?
Well, I created this slide for you. You know, here's my problem. I love everybody in our organization, engineering organization, and people ask me what's your favorite feature, and I leave somebody out every time I do that. So this is not my top 10. It's not ordered. But as I went through and looked at the public preview documentation we're putting together, these are things that just stuck out for me. I mean, thinking about linking Synapse for SQL, which is an announcement we made, by the way, in build, not just linking Synapse for SQL Server 2022, but also for Azure SQL Database. This very easy way of just seamlessly getting data into analytics for Synapse. That's a big part of it. But here's one thing that I haven't talked as much about during private preview, and that's integrating Azure Arc during the setup process. So if you want to do Azure Active Directory, if you want to do Purview, if you want to use that new Azure Arc enabled technology, it's now in the SQL Server setup bit. So you go into the GUI, you put in your Azure information, and now you're connected to Azure to light up some new scenarios. So that's kind of something that's landed. It's brand new. People haven't seen it even in the private previews. And then of course, it goes without saying that this whole built-in query intelligence, parameter sensitive plan optimization, Anna, we have finally saved the world from parameter sniffing. It's hard to believe that we've done that, but we have. And this DOP feedback, I haven't talked a lot about that as much, but it's now part of this. That's a really interesting one. I've got some demos that I'm gonna share with you at the end of today's session that I've built for folks to start playing around with these features. That's an interesting one. And then you start looking at this middle area of the core engine, SQL Ledger. We made an announcement in build for SQL Ledger general availability for Azure SQL Database. And it's also part of the SQL Server public preview. One of the things we showed as a demo and build that we haven't really focused as much on is this multi-party idea. You got a supply chain, you've got multiple parties. There's no central authority for the supply chain, but they need a centralized system. They can all trust the data. And that's what Ledger can provide. We've such some very interesting scenarios in our build demos for that. And then system page latch concurrency, that just sounds like a mouthful. It sounds very technical. It's a technical product. But here's the thing, it's maybe even possible now with all the enhancements we've done through SQL Server, the last releases, and with this one, to have a hands-free tempdb. Yes, that's true. Hands-free tempdb, install SQL Server, let us pick the defaults, just use tempdb, don't configure anything else. That could be groundbreaking. David Pless and I were chatting about this over the last week or so. I've got some demos to show that actually may be possible finally. And then contained availability groups, oh my gosh. We actually kind of announced this a little bit at SQL Bits, and we made some talks about it. Didn't really hit the public news as much. But finally, you can have availability group now in SQL Server, and your system instance objects like agent jobs, logins, link servers can now be part of the availability group, and it's called contained AGs. Really exciting to see that one land. A lot of customers asking for that for like, I don't know, a decade. So it'll be really cool to see that land. And then TDS 8.0, this is kind of an interesting one. Tabular data stream is the protocol that we have for SQL Server for our communication between apps and SQL. We have a new version of that. And the reason we have new versions, we're supporting new encryption techniques, what we call strict connection encryption, where it must be encrypted. This also supports the latest version of TLS 1.3. And some really interesting technology we built into this to help avoid things like man in the middle attacks. So that one didn't get a lot of press during private preview, but I wanted to call it out because it's actually really cool technology. And then S3 data virtualization. This is becoming more and more of a popular thing. People are using S3 object storage. Our partners, Pure Storage, MinIO, Dell has a solution. All these partners have these solutions for S3. We can now use Polybase built into the engine to go after and do external tables into S3, and then even do native backup restore. So a lot of interest around this one. Didn't get as much press when we announced kind of the private preview, but wanted to call that out. And then SSMS 19. Bob, why is that on your list for SQL Server 2022? You and I's great friend and colleague now, Aaron Stellato, program manager of this area, has really done an amazing job of really looking at the strategy for Management Studio. And there is a new preview release, the version 19, that we've launched here as part of our build announcement. So look for that. That's going to be the preferred tool along with Azure Data Studio to use for SQL 2022. And of course, there's also so much stuff we're putting into the product, but these are just a few that kind of stood out for me.
Yeah, awesome. There's definitely a lot on this list. So thanks for sharing with us and sharing a little bit more about it. For folks who've been following around the SQL Server 2022 series that we've been doing, we've done a couple episodes with David Pless on some of these things. So folks might want to check that out. You know, you mentioned SSMS 19 and Azure Data Studio, and you mentioned also a couple things around Azure SQL Database. Like, I'd love to know, like, what are we doing? This big movement around developers. What are we doing for developers when it comes to Azure SQL Database?
Well, we kind of look at it this way. Build is a conference for developers, right? So if you think about and look at the screen here, these are challenges that we know developers face. It's that I need to get seamless access to data with the code I'm writing. Azure Database can be one of those databases, but it feels kind of clunky to get access and integrate it with the data. And then I need DevOps. I need to accelerate DevOps in new, exciting ways. So we made several new announcements here. So check this list out here. Number one, in public preview, a local developer experience. What do I mean by that? We've launched something called the Azure SQL Database Emulator. Imagine you, Anna, as a developer on your laptop using Visual Studio Code, right? You go in and build an Azure SQL Database application without being connected to Azure. We're going to use the power of containers to give you that local developer feel. And our great friend Silvano, who works on this, calls it the inner-outer loop. So the inner loop being is that you do local development on your laptop, or you push changes to GitHub back and forth, but you haven't even connected to Azure. Then when you're ready, using DevOps processes and CI/CD pipelines, you push those changes into Azure Database itself. Or even supporting things like GitHub code spaces, where you haven't seen that technology. You're literally using GitHub as a VM to do all your development work. So this is pretty cool technology. We're just starting the journey here, but literally is a local development experience for Azure Database developers. And then look at the next one, Azure Functions SQL Bindings. So now with Azure Functions, with people just love that technology, we can do easy binding. That's the integration of data with those functions for either input or output of your Azure SQL Database information. So before, it's very clunky using Azure Functions to make all this work. Now, as a developer, Azure Functions and Azure Databases will feel like this to you. And then we know JSON's super important. So we have JSON functions that we've added into the product to make JSON a much more integrated feel into the T-SQL language. And by the way, that works not only for Azure SQL Database, but that's also in SQL Server 2022. A private preview for something called HTTPS endpoints or REST endpoints. This is a really interesting one. You're a developer, you like the database, you like doing server-side programming, but you want to take data from the database and push it to a REST endpoint. Okay, well, how do you do that today? You can't. It's really hard to do. You have to actually build client code to make that work. So now we're introducing a series of SQL procedures for you to take data that you can consume inside the database and push that into a REST endpoint. You may have seen in our build presentation, my colleague Drew do some really interesting end-to-end development scenarios showing all of this stuff together. And that new REST endpoint is a private preview. Go look for that. We have a sign up where you can get involved in that program. And then finally, as I mentioned, the general availability of SQL Database Ledger, that's for Azure SQL Database. That includes things like automatic digest storage for you. That's a very well-integrated field for developer. And of course, Ledger being that tamper evidence technology using power blockchain inside SQL is also in the public preview for SQL Server 2022. So look at all this stuff, Anna, just lots of announcements, right?
Yeah, there's definitely a lot here, a lot in SQL Server 2022 as well. You know, as we kind of wrap, Bob, what's your advice? Where should people start?
Lots of resources. Get SQL Server 2022. We talked about that. The next one, AKS MS SQL Server 2022, that's our main webpage. It's kind of like a central place for you to go and get information about the release as we move down this path towards general availability. And of course, here's the link for Data Expose Show. You know, we have a series we've done with you. We're going to continue doing that with you in this calendar year. So if you want to see that series, you'd go there. And then I couldn't help but add this in here. See where it says Bob SQL Demos? Like, why would it say Bob SQL Demos? That's my GitHub repo, but I've got a little surprise for everybody. In that repo is a folder called Demos and SQL Server 2022. I've built about 6 or 7 different scenarios out there that you can go right now and try it with your public preview to go see what is parameter sensitive plan optimization. What is DOP feedback? What is SQL Ledger? If you want to try out what's this TempDB thing he's talking about, I've already built these things. It's a pretty rough, just step-by-step process, not a full set blown workshop yet, right? Hint, hint. But anyways, it's a set of labs you can go through to see and just get your hands immediately on with SQL Server 2022. And of course, we have a link here for Synapse link for SQL. If you want to go right to that technology, either with SQL Server or Azure SQL Database. And then Azure SQL Database, you go to this link to see all our new announcements. And then the last one is interesting. I didn't mention this as part of our announcement. Sunitra, our great colleague in the Purview team, did a really slick demo for something called Dynamic Lineage with Azure SQL. Really interesting technology, the ability to track changes and look at dependencies across all your different types of SQL programming assets. And her demo that she showed was really powerful because it's all about runtime analysis instead of static analysis. So if you've got some SQL code, you need to go certainly check out that technology as well.
Awesome. Cool. Well, Bob, it's always a pleasure to have you on the show. Thanks so much for joining us. To our viewers, thanks so much for joining us. Go ahead and get hands-on with SQL Server 2022. Check out some of these other great resources that Bob shared. And if you like this video, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment, and let us know what you think of all these build announcements. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.